Hi children, good morning, good morning to all of you. Welcome to our St. Clair School online classes children, right? Regarding IIT chemistry for the 9th class, we are discussing now one of the concepts that is the organic chemistry children. So in that organic chemistry, in the last classes we discussed about what is the introduction about organic chemistry and what are the differences between organic substances and inorganic substances. And what is the classification of hydrocarbons? So these are the topics we are discussing in the last sessions, right children? So today we are going to discuss about one of the important point regarding organic chemistry. What is that means? Here how to write the formulae of organic compounds, right children?
Here formulae of organic substances.
Right children, see here, we have to write the formulas or formulae of organic compounds in the form of three forms. We are writing in the form of three. So what are those three forms means? The first one is complete structural formula. Right children, complete structural formula. Complete structural formula. And the second one is condensed formula. Condensed formula. Then third one is bond line formula. Children, bond line formula. Okay. So these are the three types of structures we have to write for the organic compounds. Right children, first one is complete structural formula. So what is the complete structural formula? So we have discussed one by one. So then after that condensed formula, then after that bond line structural formula. Right children, see here, when we are explaining this complete structural formula about the complete structural formula, condensed formula, bond line formula, we will take one more example and how to write these three forms of the organic compounds we will explain now. Right children? So first of all we have to take some examples from the alkanes, alkenes and alkynes. Right children? See here, suppose if we can take the one of the examples, first one what we are saying here, complete structural formula. Complete structural formula. Right children, see here, complete structural formula for this. First of all, suppose we can take one of the examples here, C9H20. What is that? C9H20. See here, C9H20 means what we are saying here. According to the formula, CnH2n+2. What we are saying here? C9H2n8+2. So this is you have to consider as a no name. What you learn? No name. It is the alkane. It is the alkane and it is also you have to consider as a saturated hydrocarbon. What you learn? Saturated hydrocarbon. Now, how can you write the complete structure of this formula for the no name means? We have to take the 9 carbons and they are given here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right, and here how many hydrogens we have? 20. So all are here, it is given here A. Alkane means in between all carbon atoms we have only single bond. So then we have to draw the single bond between carbon, 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 carbon. All are single bonds. Right children? After that, here what we have the terminal carbons. So what we have the terminal carbons? We have to take in our three hydrogens. Hydrogen. Hydrogen, hydrogen. And here is the terminal carbon here. Hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. Totally how many children? Here 3 hydrogens, here 3 hydrogens. So remaining we have 14 hydrogen. Here hydrogen, hydrogen. Hydrogen, hydrogen. Hydrogen, hydrogen. Hydrogen, hydrogen. hydrogen, 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 hydrogen. Here, when we are drawing by this, here each and every carbon it can start with its tetravalence nature. See here, this is a carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4 bonds are there, and this is a carbon surrounded by 4 bonds. Similarly, this is a carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4. Similarly, this carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4. Like all the carbons are attained, it's tetravalence nature of the carbon. Okay, right, children? So, this is the formula we have considered as a complete structural formula of nonane. Complete structural formula of nonane. Right, children? So, for this complete structure of formula of nonane, we have to write the condensed formula. We have to write the condensed formula. Here we have to write the condensed formula. What is the condensed formula means? Here, what is the group symbol here? CH3. So, simply we have written as CH3. Again, it is CH2. Again, it is CH2. Again, it is CH2. Here, CH2. Here, CH2. Here, CH2. Here, CH2. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right, children? So, without representation of any bonds, without representation of any bonds, we have to write the only what we have the atoms and number of atoms of different various elements we have write like this. Right, children? See here CH3, CH2, 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 then CH3. This is we have to consider as a condensed formula of nonane. Suppose if you want to write the bond line formula. Suppose if you want to write the bond line formula. Suppose if you want to write the bond line formula for this nonane means here how many carbons we have children? So 9 carbons. See here this is the one of the carbon. This is represented about CH3. This is represented about CH3. Again here carbon, single bond hydrogen and hydrogen. Hydrogen and hydrogen. And after that, here like this, we have written here CH3, CH2, CH2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this is the terminal carbons we have represented about CH3. And here middle one what we take in here, this is the CH2, 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 CH2 and CH2. Right? So this is the formula we have to consider as a bond line formula of nonane. Bond line formula of nonane. See here bond line formula of nonane means here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this is the bond line formula of nonane. So these three are three types of formulas of one compound, that is the nonane. So this is the complete structure of complete structural formula of nonane. It is a condensed formula of nonane. It is about bonded formula of nonane. Right, children? So these are the three different ways we have to write the one organic compound in a three different manner. Right, children? And I will give two more examples. See here, some more examples we have explained here. Suppose see here, suppose if we can take one more example, carbon, hydrogen, suppose if we can take carbon, hydrogen, hydrogen, like this. See here, suppose if you want to explain about pentane, suppose you want to about, explain about pentane. Pentane means here C5H10, C5H10. So which then the formula first one is complete structure formula. One here carbon, 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 carbon. So totally five carbons are there. So this is a pentene. So E means here must be rather one double bond between any two carbon atoms. Suppose if we take here now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, right, children. See here number of carbons. Terminal carbons must be hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. And here this is the carbon here, hydrogen, hydrogen. All this is the carbon surrounded by three bonds, 1, 2, 3. That means we have written here hydrogen. Again, this is the carbon. So 1, 2, 3. Here we have to draw the hydrogen. Again, this is the carbon, hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. This is the complete structural part of pentane. Complete structural formula of pentane. Suppose if you want to write the condensed formula, means just we have to write CH3, CH2, CH, CH, and then this CH3. Or we have written as CH3, CH2. Again, here two formulas are there, C2H2 and CH3. Right, children. So we are right. Condensed the complete structural formula. Right, children. So here this is a we have written as we have saying that condensed formula. Condensed formula. So for this, suppose you want the bonding formula. So bonding formula means, see here, one of the carbon. Here carbon, hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. Again, single bond, carbon, hydrogen, hydrogen. Again, carbon. Here carbon along with the 1, 2, 3. Carbon along with what we have? Double bond. Double bond, double bond, and here this is the carbon having how many hydrogens? One hydrogen. This is the carbon having one hydrogen. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, this is the carbon having carbon with the hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. So simply in case we have to written as something written as here. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. Right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here, this is we have to consider as a bond line formula of pentane. Bond line formula of pentane. This we have to consider as a bond line formula of pentane. Right, children. So this is about to. First example, we are taking only alkanes. By taking alkanes, we have drawn the structure. Then the second example, we have taken the alkene and then given the three forms of complete structural formula of pentane and concealed formula of pentane and bonded formula of pentane. Now we have taken alkynes. We have taken the alkynes. See, children, suppose if you want to take alkyne. Alkyne means here, suppose if you can take one of the example, you should take enzyme or heptane as you wish. Here, suppose if you can take one of the example, heptide. Heptide. So heptide means 7 carbons are there. So here C7 and heptide. 7 × 2 = 14 − 2. 14 − 2 means 12. C7H12. So totally 12 hydrogens are there. You should draw the 7 carbons. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 carbons are there. And this is your consider I. I means in between any two carbon atoms we have to draw the one triple bond. As you wish here or here as you wish. Suppose if we can draw the triple bond here. Right, children? And now remaining all are single bonds. Remaining all are single bonds. Here first carbon we have taken as hydrogen, 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 and here hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. Suppose if we can take this carbon, all these the carbon surrounded by 4 bonds. 1, 2, 3, 4 bonds. And this is the carbon 1, 2, 3, 4 bonds. Again, this is the carbon 1, 2 carbon, 2 bonds are there. You should draw the 2 hydrogens. Again, this is the carbon. 2 hydrogens. Again, this is the carbon 2 hydrogens. Now, we have to count the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hydrogens 3, 5, 7, 9, plus 3, 12. C7, H12. This is the, we have to consider as a complete structural formula of complete structural formula of heptide. Actually, so for this formula, suppose if you want to write the condensed formula, C here, CH3, CH2, 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 two carbon atoms come, C2, CH3. Actually, so this is we have to consider as a condensed formula. Condensed formula of peptide. Condensed formula of peptide. Now coming to the bond line formula. See here, one formula. Which is the position we have? 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the position we have. Single bond is there. First carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fifth carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fifth carbon having triple bond. Fifth carbon having triple bond. And with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Excellent. First carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon, sixth carbon, seventh carbon. That means triple bond can be located between the 5 and 6th carbon. See here, first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon, sixth carbon, and this is the 7th carbon. So this is where it considers a bond line formula of bond line formula of heptide. Right, so this is the one of the example for three formulas, that is the complete structural formula, conventional formula, and the bond line formula. So now we have to take these three how it will be present in the one compound. We have to draw this here. Suppose if you can take the example here, two ethyl, three methyl. Heptane. Suppose if we can take this one, 2 ethyl, 3 methyl, heptane. That means, see here children, how many then given hept? Hept means 7 carbons together. So together we have to draw the 7 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right? So they are given N. N means all the single bonds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All the single bonds. And here, 2 ethyl. Here ethyl means what children? We know that C2H6 means we have to consider the ethane. We have to consider the ethane. From ethane, when we are remove the one hydrogen, we have to consider the C2H5. C2H5 we have to call as ethyl. That means from alkanes, when we remove the one hydrogen, those compounds we have to consider the alkyl. What children? Alkyl. This is that what we are saying here. Ethane. From the ethane, if you remove one hydrogen, we are called as ethyl. And similarly, methane. So the formula of methane is CH4. When you remove one hydrogen, we are considering CH3 as methyl. CH3 as a methyl. So the given position. Second position, we have to substitute ethyl. So if we have to count from either from left to right or right to left, no problem at all. First of all, we have to draw here 2 ethyl. Here C2H5. And here 3 methyl. Here methyl group we have to draw here CH3. Okay. Then here number of carbon atoms 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 is over. And second position ethyl group is there, third position ethyl group is there. Remaining here, hydrogen. That means if I CH5 also written as CH2CH3. See here, second carbon having C2H5, like this. And here, it is the methyl group, hydrogen. And remaining here, 1, 2, 3. Here 1, 2, 3. Hydrogen. Here hydrogen. Here hydrogen. hydrogen, 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 and hydrogen. Right, children? So this is we have to consider as a complete structural formula of 2-ethyl-3-methyl-heptane. 2-ethyl-3-methyl-heptane. Suppose if you want to write this formula for as a condensed formula, as a condensed formula means we have drawn here CH3. And second condition, what have to learn? So first CH, and here we have a substituent there, that is the C2H5. Should write in bracket. Should write in a bracket. CH, C2H5. Again, third carbon having CH. And one of the substituent group, that is the CH, we have written in bracket. Then after that CH2, 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 CH3. So this is the one of the condensed formula, one of the condensed formula of 2-ethyl-3-methyl-heptane. 2-methyl-3-methyl-heptane. Okay, children. And now coming to the one of the bond line structure formula for 2-ethyl-3-methyl-heptane. You should draw like first of all heptane. So heptane means here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Then we have first carbon here. This is the first carbon. Second carbon we have ethyl group is there. Ethyl group is there means we have drawn it. This is the CH2 and CH3. Here, this is your considered as a CH3, CH, CH2, CH3. Okay. And again, here second carbon having one methyl group. Draw it. This is the only one methyl group. And again, CH2, 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 CH3. So this is we have to consider as a bond line formula of bond line formula of 2-ethyl-3-methyl-heptane. Okay, children. So this is about one of the example for how to write the complete structural formula, condensed formula, and bond line formula. And we have to give so many examples for these three types of compounds. Right, children? So this is about how can you draw the formula of organic compounds in the three forms, like complete structural formula, condensed formula, and bond line formula. Right, children? So now we will take one of the example here. Okay, we will take another example. Suppose if you want to identify the organic compound, how can you identify the primary carbon, secondary carbon, tertiary carbon, and quaternary carbon? How can you identify that? Right, children, see here. How can you identify the primary carbon and secondary carbon and tertiary carbon and quaternary carbon? That's right. So first of all, primary carbon or secondary carbon, suppose if I am drawn here one of the formula CH3, CH2, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3, again CH2. Okay, see here, I am writing this compound. See here, this is the carbon. This is the carbon is surrounded by only one carbon. This is the carbon surrounded by only one carbon. That's why this is the carbon we have considered as a primary carbon. Primary carbon. And this is the carbon is surrounded by two carbon atoms. That's why this is considered as a secondary carbon. So this is the carbon is surrounded by 1, 2, 3. That's why this is the carbon we have considered as a tertiary carbon. And this is the carbon is surrounded by only one carbon. This is considered as a again primary carbon. And this is the carbon is surrounded by two carbon. This is considered secondary carbon. This is the carbon is surrounded by two carbon. That's why this is considered as a secondary carbon. This is the carbon surrounded by 1, 2. Here also secondary carbon. Here this is the carbon surrounded by. So that's why in this particular compound, how many primary carbons are there? So number of primary carbons are 1, and here 2, and here it is 3. So number of primary carbons are 3. Secondary carbons 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 secondary carbons. Okay, and here tertiary carbon. Only we have 1 tertiary carbon. How many tertiary carbon children? Only we have 1 tertiary carbon. Then here totally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 are there now. And one more carbon is children. So tertiary carbon is over. And now coming to the see here primary carbon 1, 2, 3, secondary 1, 2, 3, and 4 over. So 4 plus 3, 7 plus 1, 8, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So total here primary carbon, say primary carbons are 3, secondary carbons are 4, tertiary carbon is only 1. So what is the primary carbon means? How many number of carbon atoms are surrounded by one particular carbon we are considered as a number of carbons we are considered. If it is surrounded by one carbon means we are considered as a primary carbon. If the carbon is surrounded by two carbon atoms means we are considered as a secondary carbon. If the carbon is surrounded by three carbons means we are considered as a tertiary carbon. If we have taken the particular carbon is surrounded by four carbons we are considered as a tertiary carbon. Suppose for this I am one of the example children. See here, for example, if we can take the one of the compound, see here CH3, CH3, right? See here, this is the carbon is surrounded by only one carbon. This is the primary carbon. This is the carbon is surrounded by only one carbon. This is also primary carbon. This is the carbon surrounded by only one carbon. This is also primary carbon. This is the carbon surrounded by only one carbon. This is also primary carbon. But this is the carbon surrounded by 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. This is the carbon surrounded by quaternary carbon. What is that? Quaternary carbon. This is the compound. In this compound here, number of primary carbons are 4. Number of secondary carbons are not there. Tertiary carbons are not there. But quaternary carbons are 1. And actually, so like this, so what is meant by primary carbon? What is meant by secondary carbon? What is meant by tertiary carbon? What is meant by quaternary carbon? Now coming to the what is meant by primary hydrogen? Primary hydrogen, secondary hydrogen, primary hydrogen, primary hydrogen, and secondary hydrogen, and here tertiary hydrogen and quaternary hydrogen. Quaternary hydrogen. Simple children, so quaternary hydrogen is not exist because the following is the carbon is only surrounded by only 3 hydrogens but not 4 hydrogens. That's why quaternary carbon hydrogens are not available here. Only 3 hydrogens will be formed here. So primary hydrogen means the carbon which is surrounded by hydrogen, the primary carbon which is surrounded by hydrogens, we are considered primary hydrogens. Here these are the 3 hydrogens of primary hydrogens. These are 3 hydrogens of primary hydrogen. These are the 3 hydrogens of primary hydrogens. These are 3 hydrogens we have considered as primary hydrogens. And here secondary hydrogens means secondary carbon surrounded by 2 hydrogens. Those are secondary hydrogens. This is the carbon surrounded by, this is the carbon is here 1, 2, 3. See here we have one of the hydrogen. This is the carbon surrounded by 1, 2, 3, 4 bonds. So this is the carbon having only 1 hydrogen. So this is the tertiary carbon, this is the tertiary hydrogen. Similarly here this is the carbon is we have to consider as a secondary carbon having 2 hydrogens. Those are considered secondary hydrogen. Like that. So the primary carbon is surrounded by water and hydrogen. Those we are considered as primary hydrogens. secondary carbon, what are the hydrogens and some of the secondary carbon we have considered secondary hydrogen, like that. These are, this is about what is going to primary carbon, what is going to secondary carbon, what is going to tertiary carbon, what is going to quaternary carbon, and about primary hydrogen, secondary hydrogen, and tertiary hydrogen. So this is about one of the small topic we have in our organic chemistry. Actually, in this class we discussed about only complex structural formula, condensed structural formula, and Mondlane formula. And what is going to be primary hydrogen, secondary hydrogen, tertiary hydrogen, and primary carbon, secondary carbon, tertiary carbon, and quaternary carbon. Actually, so this is about one of the small concept in our organic chemistry. And we'll discuss some more points in the next class. Okay, children. So please, all of us, stay home, stay healthy, take care.